Hey there, buddy. Week 16 of the CFL sure was something, wasn't it? We had crazy highs, crazy lows for some teams. Every game seemed to be exhilarating. Well, CFL Jim here to give you the lowdown and walk you through everything that just happened because, oh boy, this is a very fun, very educational week of Canadian Football League action. Let's get into it. The Hamilton Ticats taking on the Toronto Argonauts, with the Ticats winning this one 33-31. Oh boy, what a back and forth game this was. Hamilton getting down the field easy. Toronto early sort of struggling but finding their stride, running the ball. Chad Kelly taking what the defense gave him for the most part. And this game was just bananas. It was a beautiful way to start off the weekend. This was a can't lose for the Hamilton Ticats if they want to have a dream, a hope, keep that thin line of them potentially making the playoffs still alive. And they did it. Congratulations. Bo Levi Mitchell looked pretty good. The Hamilton defense stepped up when it had to. And just, it was just an all-around great game. Toronto didn't even play bad, but oh boy. This is all about Hamilton right now. They complete the sweep of the Argonauts. They are still alive. The fact that this team isn't dead says a lot about the CFL in 2024. Man, Toronto, I'm not too worried about them going forward. I think they're still in a really good spot. They had moments in this game that they still very easily could have won it. Special teams, not to the level that I usually hold Toronto to, but it's okay. It's okay. For some reason this season, they just, maybe it's all the years past. Maybe it's all the years of picking on the Ticats year in and year out. The karma has finally come for Hamilton to just be able to own Toronto, which is something I never thought I'd say in like the last 4 or 5 years, honestly. Looking forward to each team for the Toronto Argonauts, you're fine. You're still in a good spot. The defense maybe took a step back this week, but I still believe in this team. I still believe in the power of the Argos. I believe they're one of the teams with a lot of momentum going into the end of the season, and I think they're going to be all right. For the Hamilton Ticats, find a way to keep this momentum going and rank it into another win. That's going to be what I'm watching out for in Hamilton in Week 17, is if they can keep this momentum going right off this high and get another win in the column. I don't know if they're going to make the playoffs, but I just want to see them keep this momentum, you know? Game number two, we had the Calgary Stampeders facing off against the Saskatchewan Roughriders, with the Roughriders winning this one 37-29. Oh, boy. The Stamps were down early. They claw their way back, and then they make a boneheaded decision at the end of the game. You're at you have 1 yard to go. You don't bring in the most consistent player in the CFL in Tommy Stevens to get you that 1 yard. I don't understand it. Why do you try and get cute there? It just blows my mind because you were about to make the comeback. You were doing it. This game started out Saskatchewan blowing out Calgary, making it look easy. This was a can't lose situation for the Rough Riders if they want to keep their playoff spot like intact. And they almost blew it, because Calgary was starting to do stuff in the second half here. This is a team of chaos. They kind of muddled things up a bit. This wasn't even a bad Jake Maher game, but the last decision from your coach, I don't understand it. I don't understand it whatsoever. The guy we need to talk about, though, with this matchup, in this game in particular, and honestly for the last few weeks, I understand Saskatchewan's gotten Trevor Harris back, but you know what? He hasn't looked up to what he was showing early on in the season. The main man that we got to talk about here for Saskatchewan is Rock Armstead. Oh my God. He's been killing it since he joined the Rough Riders. He was doing good at Ottawa. Now he's doing good in Saskatchewan. He's making this offense just turn. He's doing a lot here, and he is going to will this team. If it's on his back, this team can make the playoffs and maybe even do some damage. Oh boy, he's fun to watch. Bull. For Calgary though, you get you embrace the chaos team lifestyle, sometimes you come with these dumb losses. It's just what happens. This was a perfect get-right spot for the Rough Riders, and they got right. Looking forward to each team. For the Calgary Stampeders, you are the team of chaos. You're probably right now, overall, the worst team in the CFL. You have little to no identity, and you just need to drag teams down to your level. That's how you're going to kind of make a name for yourself. So you're still technically alive. I just don't believe in you. For the Saskatchewan Rough Riders, you got the win. You needed this. You had to, like, feel once again what a win felt like. And now you can maybe do something with this. Take it. Improve Trevor Harris. But Rock Armstead, you got to win through the run. That's how this Saskatchewan team has to win going forward. Game number three, we had the Montreal Alouettes taking on the Ottawa Rough Riders.
Ottawa Rough Riders.
Ottawa Rough Riders.
Something new. Stop! The Alouettes winning this one 24-12. This is a game where neither offense, I think, looks spectacular. Montreal, since Fajardo's been back, they've been still kind of like pittering out on offense, but the defense for this team is just mwah. The main difference, though, was that Cody Fajardo could make the big plays when he needed to. Drew Brown, rough early. Rough game for Drew Brown. And even when Jeremiah Masoli came in, he still wasn't like cooking, if you know what I mean. Ottawa, I still think they're a fine team. Montreal, get right spot at least to get a win. I still don't know if I'm trusting this offense the way they're playing right now. But this was a very nice win to see. At least you have your quarterback making the clutch plays. Even if you're not consistently moving the ball down, it's nice to be able to just see some improvement, and that when you need to move the ball or have a big play, Fajardo still has that in him right now. That's something I think Montreal is going to need, especially if their defense keeps playing at this very high level. Ottawa, a big thing for me in this game, couldn't really run the ball, and Drew Brown having one of his worst games of the season. You're going to lose that game every single time. When you got to bring in Masoli, you just know you're not in a good spot. And that's no slight against Jeremiah Masoli. I think he's a very good quarterback. I think he's a gamer. I think he's clutch. But Drew Brown is what they were riding for the past, like, I don't know, 5 weeks, 6 weeks. He's looked good. And to have a game like this is a little worrying. Going forward for each team, for the Montreal Alouettes, nice to get back in the win column. You still have that playoff spot locked up. You're still just, you probably have first place locked up, if we're being fully honest here. And you just need to kind of tool some things on offense to get a little bit more consistency going. For the Ottawa Red Blacks, kind of, you saw some issues here. They were brought to light. Take a look, address them going forward. That's what you have to do if you're the Red Blacks. Take a look at all your issues, find some rhythm on offense, and you can still win almost any game in this league. It's going to be very, very interesting seeing all these teams down the stretch. Game number four, we had the Edmonton Elks facing off against the Winnipeg Blue Bombers, with the Bombers winning this one 27-14. This was a game! What a perfect beginning to the week, and what a cap to end it all off. This game was The score does not show how close this game actually was. Such a defensive battle throughout, and then just in the fourth quarter, Winnipeg blows the doors open. They just needed that little bit at the end. Edmonton, you got Trey Ford back in. Maybe you got the bad game out of the way. This was Trey Ford's worst game of his career so far. It's nice to get it out of the way. And you can always just look back and figure it's basically impossible to win a game when you have that many turnovers, okay? It's not going to happen. Winnipeg, their defense, still immaculate. Their offense, still leaving a little bit to be desired. Zach Claros played better in this one. He had some very clutch throws. And you kind of picked the right spot to have Sergio Castillo have his worst game of the season. Double doink. The same upright twice. You don't like to see that, but I think overall he's been consistent enough that you're still not worried. Edmonton, I think you're going to be fine. I think this game showed that you can still compete. The fourth quarter is the fourth quarter, but for three and a quarter quarters, you were in this game. You had chances to win it, but you just kept given the ball over. And even then, the fact that you turned the ball over so many times and you still had opportunities to win should tell you that this team is a different team than the Edmonton of years past. I also just need to set aside Oliveira, dude, Rankin, dude. Both running backs in this game were just mwah for both teams. It was beautiful to see. Winnipeg just made the clutch plays when they had to. Edmonton just wasn't doing it. It wasn't happening today. I also have to say for Edmonton, perfect example of what I want to see in a flea flicker. I've always said, when you play a flea flicker, either the best thing will happen or the worst thing will happen. And this was a perfect example of the best thing, best case scenario.
The shotgun. Rankin again. Flea flicker. Ford towards the end zone. Geno Lewis.
Going forward, for the Winnipeg Blue Bombers, they're playing the best kind of ball right now. This defense is lights out. They're beautiful. Just keep cleaning up the offense, and you're going to be probably the Grey Cup favorite going forward. For the Edmonton Elks, you're still fine. You're still a really good team, but you got to get some of these wins now. You're in crunch time. You're in must-win territory. You got to be playing like your life depends on it, because you still have a shot. You have a shot to make the playoffs, and that is... Who would have thought after week four that we'd be saying Edmonton Elks have a legitimate shot to make the playoffs, huh? Not me. Not me. That was weird. Anyway, that'll lead me into my audience question of the week. What teams do you guys think missed the playoffs? But the big question is, why do you think they missed the playoffs? If you think the Elks make it and the Rough Riders get kicked out, why? If you think Calgary makes it somehow, why? If you think somehow Toronto falls out, why? If you think Ottawa somehow doesn't make it but Hamilton climbs up, why? I need to know why you think these teams make it or don't make it. That's my question to you out there. And that brings me into my CFL Jim power rankings for week 16 of the CFL by me, CFL Jim, for you CFL loving folks out there who watch the CFL, both on TSN and CTV, every single week, enjoying the Canadian Football League, like me, CFL Jim, and all fans of the CFL. It's a beautiful league, and here are my beautiful CFL Week 16 power rankings. At number 9, I'm going to have the Calgary Stampeders here. This team is a team of chaos, but they're still just that. I think they don't really have, out of all the teams in the league, they're the one most lacking an identity. And that's not going to do it. That's going to put you at the 9th spot almost every time. At number 8, it's the Saskatchewan Rough Riders. Good job getting a win, but you got to do a little bit more than that to get out of the shit that you guys have been in. Because you guys have been playing real sloppy for far too long to climb out of the dredges. So you're still at the 8th spot. At number 7, it's the Hamilton Tiger Cats. Oh boy, this team has been feisty and fun for these past couple weeks, and that's very exciting, but still only has them at the 7th spot. At number 9, it is the Edmonton Elks, falling little by little. I still think they're a really good team. I think they have all the momentum in the world potentially. I think they can take away a lot of positives from week 16, but I still don't believe right now that they're ahead of the teams above them. At number 5, they didn't play. It was the BC Lions, week off, but I still have them here. I am worried about what they're doing with the quarterback situation. The defense leaves a lot to be desired. I just think right now they're a little bit better. They're kind of that cutoff team right now. At number 4, it is the Toronto Argonauts. Defense stellar. Special teams for the most part really good. And offense, when it's on, boy, is it on. They just have to work on consistency. At number 3, it is the Ottawa Redblacks. Still just a consistently good team. Ottawa, good. Ottawa means good in native Canadian, just so you know. At number 2, it is the Montreal Alouettes. Defense, stellar. Offense, if it was playing like it was in week 3, 4, 2, 1, I'd have them easy at the number 1 spot, but they're just not there right now. And for a team that has a stellar defense and an offense, there's a team doing that way better than Montreal, and that is number 1, the Winnipeg Blue Bombers. This team is mwah. Who would have thought midway through the season that the Winnipeg Blue Bombers would sit atop my power rankings and probably get the first spot in the West? And probably at this point make the Grey Cup. Wow. Who would have thought we'd been here? But it's a tale as old as time. Winnipeg, like, picking it up, doing great at the end of this season. Ugh, it's just, I'm sick of it. I'm sick of it. Well, bud, those are my thoughts from week 16 of the CFL. As a fan, week, great week. I had a blast, and I can't wait for more weeks like this as we get closer and closer and more teams start to, like, fight and claw their way into the playoffs. I expect only more excitement in this beautiful, beautiful game. I just, I'm so happy right now. I'll see you next time, buddy. Okay? I gotta check this out.